Welcome to our YouTube tutorial on creating a salary info program in C# in this session. We'll embark on a journey to develop a comprehensive program that efficiently manages and calculates salary information. Whether you're an aspiring programmer or a seasoned developer looking to expand your C# skills, this tutorial will provide you with valuable insights and practical knowledge to build an effective salary management tool. Get ready to dive into the world of C# programming and discover how to streamline salary calculations and data management with our step-by-step guide. The purpose of this program is to create a C# application that calculates an employee's salary, taking into account various factors like the rate per day, tax deductions, and more. By collecting essential information about the employee, such as their name and rate per day, the program will provide detailed salary-related calculations. These calculations include determining the employee's salary for different time periods, the rate per hour, and applying a tax deduction of 12%. The primary objective is to simplify the process of salary calculation, making it useful for both employees and employers. Accurate salary calculations hold significant importance in the professional world. For employees, it ensures that they receive fair compensation for their work, allowing them to manage their finances and meet their financial goals. Employers benefit by having a structured system that calculates wages, which helps in budgeting and maintaining a motivated workforce. You are tasked with developing a C# program to assist in calculating various aspects of an employee's salary based on user-provided information. The program should prompt the user for the employee's name and their rate of pay per day. Once this information is obtained, the program should perform the following calculations. 1. Calculate the salary for 15 days. The program should multiply the rate per day by 15 to determine the employee's salary for half a month. 2. Calculate the salary for 30 days. Similarly, the program should multiply the rate per day by 30 to determine the employee's salary for a full month. 3. Determine the rate per hour. Assuming an 8-hour workday, the program should divide the rate per day by 8 to determine the rate per hour. 4. Calculate the salary for 300 hours. The program should multiply the rate per hour by 300 to determine the potential salary for 300 hours of work. 5. Calculate a 12% tax deduction. The program should calculate a 12% tax deduction based on the employee's monthly salary, 30 days pay. Finally, the program should display the collected employee name, the results of the above calculations, including the salary for 15 days, salary for 30 days, rate per hour, salary for 300 hours, and the 12% tax deduction. This is the source code example based on the tasks required. Watch the video on how to download and execute the example source code. Thank you. This C-sharp program serves the purpose of calculating an employee's salary based on the rate per day and performing related calculations. It follows these essential steps. Program introduction. The program provides an introductory message to inform the user about its purpose. User input, employee's name and rate per day. It prompts the user to enter the employee's name and rate per day, which are required for calculating the salary. The program stores the employee's name in a variable and declares a variable to hold the rate per day. Rate per day input validation. To ensure the input's validity, the program employs a loop that continues until the user enters a valid, non-negative number for the rate per day. This is achieved by using the double try parse method to validate the input. If an invalid input is provided, an error message is displayed, prompting the user to re-enter the rate per day. Salary and tax calculations. Once valid input is obtained, the program performs various calculations. These include calculating the salary for 15 and 30 days based on the rate per day, determining the rate per hour, assuming an 8-hour workday, calculating the salary for 300 hours, and computing a 12% tax on the salary for 30 days. Display results. After these calculations, the program displays the results to the user. This includes presenting the employee's name, salaries, rate per hour, and the calculated tax. Program exit. Finally, the program allows the user to review the results by waiting for any key press before exiting. Here are some advanced challenges and exercises to enhance the salary info program. Multiple employees. Modify the program to handle multiple employees' information. Ask the user how many employees they want to calculate salaries for, and then take input for each employee's name and rate per day. Calculate and display the salaries for all employees. Dynamic tax rates. Instead of a fixed 12% tax rate, allow the user to input the tax rate. This feature will make the program more versatile for different taxation systems or scenarios. Hourly wage variations. Modify the program to accept variations in the number of hours worked per day, allowing for more accurate hourly wage calculations.
Additional deductions. Implement a feature that allows the user to enter additional deductions, e.g., health insurance, retirement contributions, and factor these into the salary calculation.
1. How is invalid input handled when the user enters the rate per day? A. The program closes immediately. B. An error message is displayed, and the program continues to run. C. The user is asked to input another value. D. An exception is thrown. Correct answer is letter B. 2. What does the variable tax represent in the program? A. The employee's name. B. The rate per day. C. The calculated salary for 15 days. D. The 12% tax on the salary for 30 days. Correct answer is letter D. 3. In the program, what happens when the user enters a negative rate per day? A. The program calculates the salary normally. B. The program displays an error message and continues to run. C. The program crashes. D. The program prompts the user to enter a positive rate per day. Correct answer is letter B.
4. How would you enhance the program to display salaries in a currency format, e.g., with a dollar symbol?
A. By implementing a complex currency conversion algorithm. B. By modifying the system's regional settings. C. By using a built-in formatting feature to display currency. D. By writing a separate currency conversion program. Correct answer is letter C. 5. What is the line console? Read key, do at the end of the program? A. Closes the console window. B. Prompts the user to press a key. C. Saves the output to a file. D. Repeats the program. Correct answer is letter B. I want to take a moment to express my sincere gratitude for tuning into our tutorial on creating a salary info program in C#. I hope this video has provided you with valuable insights and practical knowledge to effectively manage salary calculations and data with confidence. If you have any further questions or need additional assistance, please don't hesitate to reach out in the comments section below. Your support and engagement motivate us to continue creating informative content. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more exciting tutorials and programming tips. Thank you once again for being a part of our learning community.